Greetings, YouTube explorers, and welcome to the Mechanics of Thought. What is artificial intelligence? The idea of creating an intelligent and possibly sentient machine is one that stretches back for millennia, from ancient Greek mythology to the reports of an artificer in China that date back to 1000 BCE. Artificial intelligence has stimulated the imagination of mankind for generations, but it is only now, within our lifetime, that the possibility of creating a truly intelligent machine is within our grasp. AI is often thought of as the ability to bestow consciousness into a machine, or to otherwise replicate intelligent behaviours or cognition. But AI is far more wide-reaching than that, and has a wide variety of practical applications, from self-driving cars, to facial recognition, logistics, even figuring out what video should appear in the sidebar over here. It's an area that's very well known, yet very little understood, and was once described as an engineering discipline that's still an incomplete science. But I think we can think of it in much more broad terms and consider it from a variety of different perspectives, both theoretical and practical, from the philosophical to the computational. Research done under this umbrella is as diverse as it is imaginative. There are many wins to be had in studying AI, from simply being able to solve a practical problem, to being able to test our theories of neurology, and ultimately using that knowledge to interface directly with the machines themselves. So historically, computers have been very good at certain things like discrete calculations, the storage and recollection of vast sums of data, they can think in dimensions that we can't even imagine. But they tend to be bad at a lot of things that we take for granted. For example, the ability to generalize, pattern recognition, and dealing with the vague ambiguities of real life. As well, there are certain tasks that are still an open research question, like movement, language, and vision. So AI is basically trying to bridge that gap between the things that computers have traditionally been very bad at and humans have been very good at. We want intelligent behaviors, but in order to get them, we need to create intelligent machines. Using approaches adopted within AI can allow us to overcome problems that have plagued computer scientists for decades. So in this sense, artificial intelligence isn't so much an end goal or a philosophical conundrum, but rather a broad set of computing techniques that yield a practical solution to things that we need doing. Some techniques are modelled on the human brain, like neural networks. Others are modelled on self-organising and decentralised systems, like flocks of birds or the behaviour of beehives. And some use the very principle of evolution itself. Many of you are probably aware that it was Alan Turing's work that led to the development of the first computer. Of course, Alan Turing's work wasn't the first computer per se, and the forerunners include, most notably, Babbage's analytical inference engines. However, the contribution that Turing made to the field is indisputable, and as such, he is rightly regarded as the father of artificial intelligence. But his work wasn't just that of a mathematical or engineering nature. He also made significant contributions to the philosophical and theoretical underpinnings that later gave rise to artificial intelligence. Famously, he asked, what would it mean for a machine to be intelligent? And from here he devised his famous Turing test, which is the idea that if you can't tell if you're talking to a machine or a human, then that machine deserves to be called intelligent. And whilst this benchmark was met by a computer program called Eugene Gustman, many people don't consider this to be truly intelligent in the way that Turing had envisioned. So anyway, after Turing came along and laid down the foundations of the modern computer, it wasn't until John von Neumann described the architecture a computer may have. As such, modern computers are often called von Neumann machines. and initially there was a great deal of optimism in this area. Pattern recognition, language translation, and problem solving were areas that were highly funded in the early days of artificial intelligence. There was, of course, the early work of artificial intelligence by McClock and Pitts, and the almost as famous historian, because he also had a film made about him, John Nash. He developed game theory, which later proved to be invaluable to the development of AI. The three laws of robotics were posed by Isaac Asimov in his also a film, I, Robot, and the first game-playing computer was devised by IBM, which played checkers. Newell, Simon, and Shaw developed Logic Theorist, which was a computer program that looked at logical symbols and analyzed the relationship between them. Many people considered this the first AI program, and some even considered it to be the first thinking machine. Prior to this, symbolic manipulation was considered to be unique to humans, so this was a really big deal. And for a good decade or so, research within artificial intelligence was going strong, but unfortunately, after such time, AI hadn't managed to fulfill many of its promises. A negative report by ALPAC, who reported directly to the US government, reported that the language translation scheme hadn't been going very well. And the otherwise inspired and always charming Marvin Minsky published a book called Perceptrons, which highlighted the limits of the early work into AI. And whilst much of what he said is true, it is thought to be partly responsible for what we now know as the first winter of AI. I think the problem is that historically we'd always assume that artificial intelligence would develop in a similar way to human intelligence, and areas like vision, like speech, and like movement, would be very easy problems to solve. And because AI hadn't managed to solve these within a decade, it was almost considered a dead end. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this very brief introduction of AI, and please subscribe if you want any more videos on artificial intelligence, neurology, philosophy, psychology, or cognitive science. Don't forget to rate and share. This is The Mechanics of Thought, signing off.